The world's leading female dating expert for men. Today, I want to look at first dates. It's a question I get asked a lot. First date locations that I think are terrible. And I am telling you this from personal experience as well as advice from a female dating coach for men. So where shouldn't you take her on a first date? Number one, formal restaurants. It's a cliche. Every guy likes to wine and dine a girl. That's what they've been taught to do. They've been taught to wine and dine her, literally. So they book a very fancy restaurant, and what happens is inevitably they are facing opposite each other. There's not a lot of background noise. They are interrupted every 5 minutes by a overzealous waiter. And there's potential for a lot of awkward silences. Also, you don't want to be taking a girl to a top restaurant on your first date. There's a lot of girls out there and they really are looking for a free meal. Sounds ridiculous in this day and age, doesn't it? But it's true, and I know a lot of women that do still do this, and they just have loads and loads of dinner dates with lots of very wealthy men, or sometimes not wealthy men, just men pretending to be wealthy, just because it's a nice evening out in a restaurant that they usually wouldn't be going to if they were paying. Second date mistake, don't take them for lunch. A lot of guys think if I take the girl for lunch, she's gonna feel relaxed and there's not gonna be a lot of pressure. That's true, but you need her to have a little bit of pressure at least to make an effort. You see, we associate lunches with friends and business meetings. You don't want to put yourself in that category. It's very hard to escalate from lunch. Also, chances that she's going to come back to your flat in lunchtime are quite low. Not impossible, but not as high as if you were taking her out in the evening. So no lunches. Another mistake is activity-based dates, such as karaoke, something where you can both do something together. This is something that's being advised by people to do recently a lot, such as playing a game together, going bowling, quasar, whatever, I don't know what you call it in America. And it's lame, and she's not a child. You know, you don't need to take her out and entertain her and buy her ice cream and play games with her. It's just all too naff. It's something that, is what you do when you're 14 years old. You go bowling together or something. So try and stay away from those kind of first dates unless you're under 18. Another date mistake. A lot of guys have done this for me, which is they've gone out on a limb almost to make it the most special event of my life. I've had hot air balloons where you know, it was like dinner on a hot air balloon somewhere, and helicopter rides around London, hired out a restaurant, and it's beautiful. I mean, you're very grateful for it, but all you're really thinking about is, I can't wait to tell all my friends about this, because the guy is now just making way too much effort for you to actually appreciate him. You are more into the actual moment of the place and what he's arranged than the moment spent with him. So if you've got the money, still no need to start hiring out places or going out on a limb for her. Not yet anyhow. Do it when you propose to her, maybe. Okay, last one, no VIP clubs. Unless you are the VIP guy there, don't take her to these places. I know a lot of guys, and they finally get on the guest list of like a really top nightclub, And they get in there and they're suddenly like the lowest guy in terms of the hierarchy in these VIP clubs, and then the girl's just not interested and she's going to be looking over in the VIP section. So if you're going to take it to a top-end nightclub, you've got to go the whole way, and you've got to have the table and so on. Otherwise, you're just going to come very low in the rankings, very low in the hierarchy, and it's not going to be attractive. So anyway, those are the things that you shouldn't do. Let's talk more about where you should take her for a date. So I've got three choices here that I want to share with you, and these three can fit all budgets. The first one is taking to a place that you feel comfortable with. Somewhere where everybody knows you, somewhere where your place in the hierarchy of that venue or that group is considerably high up. This could be a pub, it could be a club, it could be a bar, and it could be a party. This is a great way to demonstrate to the girl that you are an important person, that you have high value, that you have a lot of friends, people respect you. This is very, very important to women, and she needs to see this. So if you take her to a nightclub that you're not sure of, then you run the risk of, let's say, having a problem with the doorman there, and you have the problem of not knowing anybody and not being respected. This is a major turnoff for a woman. So if there's a party coming up, if there's a bar where everybody knows you, or there is any type of club or pub or whatever it is where you are respected and you are popular, then this is a great place for a first date. She'll feel very comfortable with it, and she won't feel like it's just you two alone. So that's a great choice. Second choice is the cinema. Okay, now a lot of people disagree with me about this, but that's cool, because every time I tell my student to take the girl to the cinema and what to do when he's in the cinema, he always thanks me for it. So let me explain why cinema date for a first date is such a good idea. What you do is you go watch the film together, and you make sure that you're going to have a bite to eat. You're gonna literally grab a bite to eat. So I advise the guy to say to her, look, we'll grab something to eat after. It's very chill and it's very relaxed. When you're in the cinema, you gotta make sure that you're talking together, okay? You gotta make sure that you're having a laugh, or you gotta make sure that you're making comments to each other in the cinema. I don't care about the other people in the cinema right now, and you shouldn't either. Just care about your date and what's happening there. So you could be laughing, it could be a horror movie where you're protecting her, anything like that. But the main reason for this is when you go to grab something to eat, whether it's a pizza or hot dogs or sushi, whatever it is, you've got something to speak about. It's not going to be that dreadful silence. People, when they come out of the cinema, if you notice, they're always talking, they're very excited, they're in a great mood. So the girl's going to be in a positive frame of mind, she's going to be really buzzy, you've got something to speak about. And this is essentially why I believe that a first date with a girl at cinema is a bit of a cliche, is actually quite effective. My third suggestion for a first date: take the girl to a really, really tacky themed bar or club, but it's got to be really tacky. I'm talking like a really bad disco, something that only tourists go to, something really, really awful. Now, why would you take her somewhere like this? This has never failed any of my students. Now, you've got a choice here. You can either tell her, listen, I'm going to the most tackiest bar in the world tonight, let's go and have fun and make fun of people. Or you can say to her, listen, I heard this club was opening. My friend told me about it, or this bar that he went to, he said it was really good, let's go check it out. Now, if you go the first suggestion and she is up for a laugh, what happens is you go into this really tacky themed bar and you create your own world, you create your own reality, just you two laughing at everybody, being silly. It's a chance for her to be silly, dance to the cheesy music, to really share a connection with you, because everybody else is not cool here. everybody else is going to be people that you probably never want to be seen dead with in your whole life, and you can both have a good time with this. Now, if you go for the second option where you say that you heard it was a really good club, the moment you walk in, make sure that you both look at each other and both give the impression of like, what are we doing here? And just say to her, you know what, we're gonna enjoy it. We're gonna just let loose, we're gonna have fun, and we're gonna just enjoy it for what it is. Now, another good reason for why a themed tacky bar for a first date is so good is because it's a great way for you to filter the girl, to assess the girl. It's a great way for you to see if the girl is cool enough for a second date, if you like her. If she's one of these girls who are like, I'm not staying here, this place is terrible, I'm walking out now, then obviously that girl is not interested in hanging out with you. She just wants to go to cool clubs, cool bars. Maybe you met her in a VIP nightclub and she's thinking, why did you take me here? Or she just wants a sit down meal. Okay, the girl's, you know, she's really not interested in having fun with you and just sharing a moment and letting her hair down. She's no fun. So that's another great way to filter out all the crap out there. But if she turns around and she's like, hey, let's have fun, you know, I don't mind doing this at all, this is kind of cool, then you know she's a really cool girl and she's interested in being with you and having a nice time with you, and it's not about the place. Actually, this tip was inspired by an ex-boyfriend of mine. We met at one of the top nightclubs in London a few years back. And what happened is he asked me out on a date, and I just expected he would take me to the opening of some nightclub because he was that kind of guy. He was in that kind of crowd. And he took me to the most tackiest bar I've ever seen. It was like Hawaiian themed bar with a bunch of backpackers and tourists and minicab drivers. It was really, really bad. It was so bad, it was good. And we went in there and my face just dropped, and he looked at me and he's like, are we gonna have fun? Look at this place, isn't it amazing? And I turned around, I said to him, absolutely, let's have a lot of fun. And we did, we had so much fun. It was great, we were making fun of people, we created our own worlds. You know, I became silly, I took off my shoes, was dancing in the middle of the dance floor, it's terrible music. So my shield came down, my bitch shield came down, and it all went well from there. So, I hope that helps. If you want to find out more about myself, my team, my courses, and obviously to read my regularly updated blog, then go to www.kezia-noble.com. I'm the world's leading female dating coach for men. My advice is 100% honest and completely direct. Thanks guys for watching this. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Lots of new videos coming up, and I hope to see you soon.